a journey of inspiration that spreads across the grain fields of Mitiana district, let alone a story of a budding star. 29-year-old Daniel Kizito is a maize farmer from Jungwe Bulera sub-county in Mitiana district. His passion for farming stems right from his childhood. Daniel's parents were seasoned farmers in Mitiana district, and this impacted on his journey into the farm fields. However, Daniel is a professional accountant with a bachelor's degree in accounting from Makerere Business School. Having practiced accounting for 3 years, Daniel quit his job and has no regrets. He takes us on his journey into farming.
I've always loved farming from the time I was a child, and I was always involved in farming with my parents when we used to come down to the farm when we were kids. So I was like, after studying, I have to go down and do farming. That's what mainly brought me into agriculture. Not the money or the what, but the love for farming at heart is what brought me here.
Even while pursuing his course in accounting, Daniel would practice part-time farming on his 20-acre piece of land. Initially, he started out with a 5-acre piece of land before expanding to 10 acres. During harvest periods, Daniel could fetch between 15 to 20 million shillings, depending on the yield. With now 2 years into mainstream farming, Daniel has set out to see his business flourish.
At the moment, I'm not earning anything much. At the moment, the money I'm earning from the maize, I'm reinvesting it. I haven't earned anything so far in the last 2 years. So I'm just reinvesting until the investment becomes stable. That's when we shall start counting the profits.
Despite acquiring more land to grow maize, it has not come without challenges.
The labor costs are very high. The labor costs account for something like 70 to 80% of the total costs. And the laborers down here in the village are very difficult people. So you have to keep on their back, and they are very costly, they are very unreliable. So if you're entirely relying on them, it's very costly and hectic.
Daniel has not been deterred, however. His future prospect is like a blooming flower in summer.
So I'm planning to expand this farm. We are planning to get my machinery. Then we have a larger farm. I'm planning to fix a maize mill to add value to our products so that we can supply maize flour instead of grain. At the moment, I'm just selling grain, and maize flour is more profitable.
Aside from growing maize, Daniel rears animals. He sells between 10 to 15 liters of milk daily. With the distance he has covered, Daniel thinks the youth can follow his path.
My message to the youth is that they should come down to the farms and start farming. They shouldn't discriminate farming and look at it as a job for peasants or poor people. If they really want to do the farming, they should come down and then start the farming. They shouldn't stick in town. It is very promising. It's a very promising business venture, much, much promising than hanging around in town, working in office.
At this stage, Daniel can only marvel at how far he has come, owing to the tough decision he had to make.